I'm ready to be exposed. I'm not sure if I'm quite mentally prepared for what's about to happen. Hey YouTube, so I was recently home at my parents' place cleaning out my closet and I found some gems, relics of the past, if you will, and among them my college undergrad pre-screening CD. So for my younger viewers who might not know what a CD is, once upon a time this is what we used to put music on. I sent this CD, not this actual CD, to the schools that I was applying to in the mail, like the USPS, where you put it in the mailbox and it's delivered. Now you all have it way easier and you just upload it online and it's there instantly. This is just a little snapshot of the reality and hardship those born in the 90s used to have to face daily. CDs. So now that we have that explanation out of the way, pre-screening is basically where you are sending a pre-audition, pre-screening. You're being screened to see if the school is even going to invite you for a live audition. With flute applicants especially, there's just way too many of us, so they need you to send the CD before you come so they don't have thousands of people showing up for the live audition. This particular musical selection on this CD was rejected by said school, which shall remain nameless. No hard feelings. In reality, it probably deserved to be rejected just based on the fact that I spelled Mendelssohn wrong. I'm hoping that this was just like a test to see if the CD burning worked and I corrected that label before I shipped it off, but who knows now. So anyway, I thought it would be some good quality flute content, what the people want, to listen to these pre-screening CDs from yesteryear. You know how when you have a concert and you think it went really horribly and all you can think about are the mistakes that you've made? Just me? Okay. But then you wait a few weeks and then you listen to the recording and you're like, oh, that wasn't as bad as I thought it was. I'm thinking this is gonna be something of the reverse. When I recorded these, I did not have the same concept of flute playing that I do today, or the same standards for myself that I do today, just because I didn't know. I was young. So basically at the time, I probably thought that I sounded way better than I actually did. We'll find out. Growing up, I was not the type of player that was in pre-college programs or any type of fancy music-only school. I went to public high school, so I was just your nerdy, classical music-loving Beethoven enthusiast. Enthusiast is probably not strong enough of a word for what I was. So let's just keep that in mind as we listen to what is on here. Some people on Instagram who are way too complimentary are often like, post recordings from when you were really young, you probably sounded amazing, and I'm just like, I mean, I guess I was good compared to the other 10-year-old flute players in my fourth grade band program, but these were probably recorded like in the fall of 2009, so that's like almost 10 years ago. Okay, well, I hope I've made some progress since then. So enough stalling, enough disclaimer, let's just get right into this. So like most laptops, this thing does not have a CD drive, but I do have this external CD, DVD type thing. So let's see if this works. Okay, I think we are in business. So there's three CDs in here. This one says College Master, which I'm assuming means like the master CD. This one has Mozart Concerto on it, oh god. And then this one here has a wide selection of things. Let me start off with this mixtape type one, if you will. We've got some Telemann Fantasy on there, that might not be so bad. If this thing doesn't play and ruins my whole video, Okay, so here goes nothing. Bad audio quality. It's honestly not as bad as I thought it was going to be. someone. We'll see what happens when we get to some other stuff, but first impression, okay. Due to you because it's 9 minutes long. I remember I had so much trouble when I went to record this because I had never played it with piano before and I just had no idea how the piano part went and it was a disaster. I think the pianist, I remember he was really frustrated with me because I just couldn't count it correctly in the beginning. So let's sample a little bit of this. It gives me like anxiety, this piece, still, just because I had that bad experience trying to record it. Okay. was going to be that bad, like missing notes, strange rhythms. I definitely did not know how to practice correctly when I was that age. I was just like playing things over and over again because I thought it sounded nice. So this piece, I still just don't really enjoy performing it. I think just because I had that traumatic first introduction to it. I remember just being so stressed out in the recording. I should have rehearsed before I tried to record it with the pianist. Like, that's just basic stuff. So yeah, rehearse before you record, kids. Just, it's a no-brainer. So, but the Dutia is, to this day, a piece that I'm just like, oh, I don't really enjoy performing it or playing it, I think because of that traumatic first experience. What about this Mozart one? Okay, so I'm pretty sure my pianist was sight reading, FYI. Hoping that I practiced between the fall and then February or whatever when the auditions were. Like, okay, so CD number 3, let's see what is on here. Wow, buzzing noise. Mozart second movement. The choose. Too loud and that you can actually hear some of the playing. Maybe it's best if you don't hear it, but so I think I expected some of it to actually be better than it was. I knew that Duetto was going to be rough because I think that memory is forever seared into my brain, but I didn't know how rough it actually was. And the Mozart, like, yeah, Mozart will just reveal everything about your playing. Mozart and Bach, and you can hear immediately how the person plays. So that was rough. But Telemann was okay, actually. And I guess my perception of what someone as a freshman going into a top music school would sound like is a bit skewed just because I can't remember. My standard back then was so much different. That was like almost 10 years ago. So it's hard to know how I compared to my freshman colleagues at the time. But I guess I'm just really thankful that Paula, my teacher at NEC, took that chance on me, and she saw how much I loved flute and how much I loved music and how much I really wanted to learn, and she saw that potential in me. So I'm really grateful to her for that, and I think this is just reminding me about that and how much I owe to her for taking a chance on me. It's also really hard to judge yourself objectively as musicians, and most human beings were self-critical, and we already hear a million things wrong with something that somebody else might not hear just because it's in our nature. So a lot can happen in your playing in 10 years, as you can hopefully hear. And I've heard some recordings of myself from like around the first semester of my freshman year, and I remember them, I hope I remember them, sounding much better than this. When you're that age, your playing is changing really rapidly, especially when you first get to conservatory and you're just nonstop working on everything. You make a lot of progress in a short period of time. I know I can get really frustrated with my playing now and think like, I haven't made any progress, I don't sound any better, but this is kind of like eye-opening, and it gives me hope that practicing productively works, and taking lessons with great teachers and applying what they've told you really works. So I hope you guys found this video interesting or entertaining. I'm gonna go practice now, play some scales and some long tones and just try to So thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you for your support as always. And you can go follow me over on Instagram if you want to keep up with me and see what else I'm up to. If you have any ideas for things you'd like to see me do in future videos, please let me know in the comments below. And I'll see you guys soon in my next video.